It's March 27. We're at the World Health Organization, and I'm talking to Thiru, who I work with, and we're here in negotiations on a pandemic treaty. Thiru, can you introduce yourself and tell people a little about yourself?
Hi, Jamie. My name is Thiru Balasubramaniam. I am Geneva representative of Knowledge Ecology International. It's a nonprofit organization that deals with access to knowledge issues and the interface of knowledge management issues with intellectual property. And I've been in Geneva for roughly 20 years representing KEI and its predecessor, CP Tech, or Consumer Project on Technology.
And can you tell people a little bit about what this negotiation is all about?
Yes, I'll try it, Jamie. So in previous negotiations, I've seen whether a WTO, WIPO, or WHO, I've seen they're a bit more narrow instruments, whereas this is a pandemic response agreement that would be quite holistic. So, for example, in some of the provisions that we are looking at, we've looked at Article 11 on technology transfer and know-how, Article 9 on research and development, but there are other sections, for example, on the earlier sections, Articles 4, 5, and 6 on surveillance, then Article 14, for example, on regulatory strengthening. So, one thing we've observed is that in the text that the Bureau published, the WHO published in early March, I think the page count of that text was around 30 pages, if I'm not mistaken. And we are aware that the latest draft from 10 p.m. last night, the 26th of March, you have a sort of, people talk about great inflation. I would say there's page inflation. So now it's around 108 pages with tons of brackets.
Yeah, I had the impression it was over 4,500 brackets in the text from yesterday. Do you think they can resolve all of those thousands of brackets by tomorrow?
I don't think so, Jamie. And that's, going into this negotiation, which started, I believe, last Monday, March 18th, there were whisperings along the corridors of an extension of this session, and it looks like that will come into play. So, yes, as you mentioned, Jamie, the meeting INB9, it was supposed to be the final marathon session of this negotiation. It's supposed to end tomorrow. But what we are hearing, although it's not officially confirmed from what I've seen, the next session will take place at the end of this month. So from Monday, March 29th to Friday, May 3rd.
Do you think the problems in getting to an agreement are more about the substance or the modalities?
That's a good question, Jamie. Outside looking in, I think a lot of it has to do with the substance, but I think modalities certainly do matter. And I think one thing we observed last week was, to remind someone himself, the drafting group was taking place last week, and it still is, but often in with many member states participating. And I think towards the end of last week, on Friday and Saturday, members decided to convene some smaller informal groups looking at specific articles. For example, one on Article 12 on access and benefit sharing, another one on Article 11, technology transfer, and another one on Articles 4, 5, and 6 on surveillance. and I got the sense, just sorry to complete my thought, I got a sense from, you know, talking to delegates recently that some of them thought that regarding your modalities question, that perhaps that could be more useful for some of the most contested provisions at such a critical stage.
There are a handful of NGOs like KEI on the ground here, and there are other people that are not able to be here that are communicating, you know, through messaging and email and things like that. What's it like for the people on the ground here? I mean, how do they try and engage and interact and influence the outcome of the negotiation?
I think that's a good question, Jimmy. I think a lot of it, the advantage of being able to be on the ground here is that, you know, even though we're not in the room, we're still able to meet delegates and bump into them, you know, in the cafeteria or up here in the mezzanine cafe. And in fact, you know, talking about modalities, I think that was a key change that I observed from last year, because at the beginning of the year, until INB7, NGOs, including, you know, groups like ours, IFMA, Four Paws, we couldn't physically get into the building. And then what I thought was quite significant was there was, towards the end of last year, Chile, on behalf of, I think, 62 countries, called for more active participation of non-state actors and relevant stakeholders. And they said, even if they can't actively participate in the drafting group, we want them on the building premises. We want, and they specifically said, we would like to be able to have coffee with them. And then the secretary said, and then they asked, you know, the bureau asked, is this possible? And the secretary said, yes. And then that's why in November and December of 2023 for INB7, the doors into the premises were finally open. And I think it makes a huge difference to be able to talk to delegates, but other, you know, other stakeholders, and also WHO staff.
Thiru, I'm going to come back to you a little later. I think I'm going to check in with some other people right now and what's going on. But before I turn off the video, is there anything you want to add?
You know, a couple of days ago when one of the texts was published, I believe, by Politico on Monday, you gave this assignment to some of us, and also, you know, other colleagues were happy to contribute. And our colleague Arianna Shutton did some excellent analysis of the brackets contained in Article 11. One thing, you know, I was just looking at the preamble language on intellectual property, and through that bracket assignment, I noticed something interesting that I think I would have caught before. Specifically, for example, there was a reference to the development of new medical products. And, you know, what I saw that surprised me a little bit was that one member state, Japan, wanted to delete that reference and just limit it to medicines. So that surprised me by doing that little bracket examination. Thanks.
Thank you very much.